Good evening, Central friends and family. It's such a joy to be up here. Well, it's not really a joy to be up here, but it will be in a minute when I'm down there watching these amazing, talented third graders. I'm Christine Kaczynski. I am the very proud principal at Central Elementary. And I have to tell you, you have some amazing children. And I'm excited to be here to celebrate their hard work over the last couple weeks. So thank you for coming out to support our students and our performing arts. It won't be long, and our students will be performing in a state-of-the-art facility, which is under construction right now. And I'm sure you noticed that with the parking lot, but that is part of our bond project. A couple housekeeping items. First of all, please silence your cell phones. And then make sure you know where you put them, because we always end up with a couple extra cell phones at the end of the night that fall out of pockets. So just if you happen to go home and lose your cell phone, let us know. We probably picked it up at the end of the night. Also, please refrain from flash photography. DTV is here recording tonight, and it does mess up the recording. Third, our third graders have been practicing being professionals. So they are going to come up here and they might see you waving like crazy. They may not wave back because they're being professional. So just keep that in mind. Also, it's very difficult to see all of you from up here with the bright lights on us. The last couple years have been what we would call maybe tricky. And it has been over 2 years since our students have been on stage. So I have to give a great big shout out to our amazing music teacher, Mrs. Rhodes. She does amazing things in the classroom. And I love going into her classroom and learning about music, which she teaches very well. She has planned virtual concerts. She has scheduled concerts, rescheduled concerts. She has done all of the things. And we finally got the go-ahead to run our concerts. Mrs. Rhodes took on the impossible task of having 4 concerts in a 3-week period. So she really wanted to get all of your students back on stage, and we're really grateful for that tonight. Without further ado, your third graders.
While our students are walking on stage, I want to take the chance to thank you for giving me such excellent students to work with. We've had a great time preparing, and you're going to see pretty quick that I think they're going to have a really good time sharing it with you. In fact, we've had to practice toning down the enthusiasm so that we're not yelling the songs because we're so excited, but actually singing them tunefully. So I've had a great time, and I hope you enjoy what it is we get to share with you today, silly and everything else. While we're still getting up here, I want to give you a quick detail about our first song. If you haven't seen Encanto yet, you're probably going to need to go see it after this to help make sense of it. This song has been the most popular one for some time. And I actually had a couple students ask to sing this beforehand, but I had this great idea where each class gets to represent one of the characters singing in that song. So you'll notice, okay, at the beginning that only one group of students is singing for a character, because the coolest part is at the very, very end, when all of the different characters sing all of their parts at the same time. This technique goes way back to like Mozart, but Lin-Manuel Miranda did a pretty good job reincorporating this idea in Encanto. So I hope you get to enjoy their storytelling and technique. Third graders, a good musician is a good
singer,
and that's what we need.
Thank you.
Could my soloists for Try Everything come on down carefully? We're gonna have to do a transition. It might take a second, but it's something we're pretty excited to share with you. But we had one thing that we thought you might be concerned about, so I wanted to make sure one of the students gave you some important information.
No third graders were harmed in the making of this production.
Miss Romzek's class, please have your helmet friends sit in front of this line, and Boomwhacker friends stand behind them with your stuff. Just Miss Romzek's class, go grab your stuff. Take it easy, James. And now, Miss Wheaton's class, can you start, get your things and be as far over as you can. Go ahead, Miss Wheaton's class. This is the last song. Remember, your helmet team needs to kneel tall. Here, you're gonna need to take the headphones. Okay, if you're sitting in the front row, make sure you're crisscross on your bottom or sitting slightly as you need to. All right. We'll start at the very beginning. Oh.
Oh.
patterns, we usually get some pretty nifty tools to help us out, like these. Now, if you're not familiar, these are called boom whackers, and each different color tube has a different length, and therefore it has a different pitch, it has a different high and low sound, and they happen to match for our song, our do, our, show them to them guys, our do, re, mi. With smaller chunks, and then we put them together like this. So singers, can you sing after me? And remember, boom whacker players, you sing and play. Here, I'll go first. So do la fa mi do re. You try.
So do la fa mi do re.
And then, well, we have one that's pretty similar, but not the same.
So do.
Together. Aha, oh, this is a long one, so you gotta wait for me.
So do la fa mi do re. So do la ti do re do.
Now it's your turn.
So do la fa mi do re. So do la ti do re do.
All right. And now, once you practice the pattern enough, that is when you change your pattern into whatever words you want. Ours is going to sound something like, when you know the notes you sing. But we're going to put it together with our do, re, mi's a few times. So let's put it together.
Thank you.
had a good time, and I hope you did too. But we're going to dismiss in just a second, but you do need to hear a couple of details. Okay, our two classes farthest to this end are going to be meeting families in the choir room. You do need to check in with their classroom teacher before you walk away with them. You can't just have everybody run out into the crowd and go to whichever grown-up is looking at them. So our first two groups, okay, Miss Meineke's class. Miss Meineke's class, could you carefully set down your boom whackers and put take your helmets with you if it's yours. Take your helmets with you if it's yours. But put the boom whackers away. In the little bucket. Mm-hmm. Okay. And rise your friends carefully. Okay. You did amazing, guys.